I mean, what's that? The only, it's nothing. The only thing missing from the end of that is like, wow, 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 wow.
She's gone a bit. Everybody seems to love her.
Hijackers and housemates seem to like her.
What are we saying about Amy, Jade?
I think she's a really nice girl. Uh-huh. Really nice. No, she honestly was a really genuine girl. But at the same time, I kind of feel like she hasn't really done what she wants to. She's kind of just played along to keep everyone happy. I don't think she's kind of...
being herself.
I don't know, she's being herself, but she's just trying to keep balance in the house rather than doing what she wants to do.
Well, listen, let's find out if Amy is Nathan's type, because we've got Miles, who's Nathan's best mate, on the phone. Hi, Miles,
hey,
how are you?
How you doing? How you doing, people?
Yeah, we're good, guys. We're good. So, listen, tell us, how's Nathan getting on there? Are we seeing the real him? Is that your mate in there?
Yeah, definitely. I think when Nathan first went in there, I don't think he knew what to expect. But I think now he's actually got comfortable because he's got to know the people a bit more in there.
Sure.
So he's opening up a lot more. So, yeah, I think he's doing good, man.
Is Amy or LaToya his type?
To be honest, I think that he's seen things in each of the girls. Like, being in there for a week, he's got to know their personalities. I don't think he's attracted to them like that. But I think that, like, he's got to know them pretty well and he thinks that, like, they've got certain qualities that are nice.
Miles, he's talked about some girl on the outside who he has feelings for. Do you know who this person is?
No, Nathan ain't got no one on the outside.
Really? Really? Because he keeps saying he's almost single and stuff like that. I mean...
Yeah, no. But I think because Chris came at him with, like, who do you like, who do you fancy? So I think he had to say that to kind of, you know, ease it down. But, no, Nathan's single, just trying to concentrate on his music, really.
Do you think this will be good for his music career, Miles?
To be honest, I think there's a lot of people out there that know about Nathan's music but don't know who he is. So he's trying to, like, get more exposure so people know about him and know about, like, could actually link his music to faith. So I'm hoping that when he comes out, it can do that.
Great. Cool. Thank you so much for calling, Miles. We'll see you soon.
Thanks,
James, is he a good bloke, Nathan? Is he a nice guy in there? He seems quite popular in there.
When I was in there, I thought he was, like, really nice, really general. He was always, like, really friendly and stuff. So on coming out and realising that he nominated me, I was like, oh, I thought you really liked me, do you know what I mean? So you don't know, but at the same time, you have to nominate someone, don't you? So.
Great.
Thanks, Jade. Now, don't be an Alexander Graham Bellend. Get in touch with us using your telephone and your voice could feature on this feature.
Now, in honour of Jade being here as our guest, during the mouthpiece, we're going to have our very own beauty pageant. Miss or Mr. Big Brothers Big Mouth 2008. Jade, you've approximately 1 minute to judge every member of the studio audience on their wit and beauty.
Coming out of the Big Brother house can be a busy time. For example, it's been suggested that the 2000 film Miss Congeniality is a documentary covering Jade's first 24 hours out of the house. Here's the mouthpiece and a synopsis of that extraordinary film.
I've just got one thing to say to Andy McDabb. You're a fucking bastard. What a freak show! Jay looks like Nosferatu. Jeremy's got the mark of Satan in the middle of his forehead.
I think Victor is worried that his sister might get off with that singer guy and he won't be able to have a partner to do a circus act with. And I think... that's what I think.
I think since Jade left, it is rubbish. Since Jade left, it was rubbish. Next, I think... sorry, I'll start again, bye.
I've never seen anybody eat so much as that Amy. Every time I look at her, she's eating. Is that all she does in the Big Brother air? I'm a great fan of Big Brother, me. I watch every single one of them. 24-7, the eyes are glued.
Oh, Victor is very, very sexy. He looks like Robert De Niro, actually. And I like him very, very, very much.
There she
Here's
is,
the winner.
Miss Big Mouth 2008. Sit on your throne. Hey! This is your throne.
Shocked.
And you win this as a prize. There's your little helmet there. And you just get to sit there for the rest of the show. There she is.
Look at her.
Thank you so much, Jade.
Thanks, Jade.
Wow.
Right. It's come to our attention that some of you went on an ad binge over the weekend. We just feel that it's our duty to say that although ads do give you a natural high and a sense of elation, please view them in moderation. It will be a long time before a government review of ads takes place, so please enjoy these ads sensibly. Roll with the come down.
Bye.
In a hijacked situation, should you always comply with the hijacker's demands?
I'd been hijacked and I took them around Hyde Park, gave them £80 and they gave me their number. They were robbers from the East End.
Tesla, who are hyped up, psyched up and ready for riding, is the studio audience.
Now, James and myself went on a double date this weekend with Ross Kemp on Gangs and his brother Hugh Fearnley Whittingstall. It was a romantic picnic, but Kemp had been at the bloody Carver all afternoon, and when Fearnley Whittingstall cracked open the Scotch eggs, Kemp on Gangs was immediately sick on himself. The topic of conversation then turned to how best to get vomit out of Kashmir. We ummed and we ahed, and Fearnley finally declared that one should put it in a barrel of tar and sticks and set fire to it. He then went about proving it. Check this.
If Scotland were to be hijacked, how would you react?
Well, if it was to be hijacked by English people, I would be very annoyed.
Probably quite fiercely, like a chilli-flavoured cocktail.
I would be totally devastated unless it was Chris Moyles.
Which celebrity would you most like to hijack Scotland?
Leona Lewis.
The Prodigy, as they are the twisted fire starters.
Olivia Newton-John.
Evel Knievel, or I think he'd stand up to the task quite well. But he's dead, isn't he? So, Shatner, William Shatner.
Can John become a Scottish folk hero like Ally McCoist or The Proclaimers?
I think he's still got quite a few things to do to get to folk hero status, but I'm sure he'll have a few things up his kilt that he'll be able to pull out the hat. Yeah, I think John could go on to become the next William Wallace.
Should John lead Scotland?
Nah.